everybody, this is TG95 here, and welcome back to Moons of Madness. Now, I know this doesn't look like where we left off. I am sorry about that. But my video got corrupted. I know, happened once before. Not for this game, but for another game. So, hopefully, this one's not going to get corrupted. Because if it does, I'm pretty sure we're almost done with the game. I'm probably going to have to replay the game, and yeah. But anyways, let's get to it. Eight-headed monster?
Keeping here.
Eight-headed monster, apparently. What's this?
New Eden. Orochi is planning on building a city here. A failsafe.
There is no escape. The dream will consume them. They are inevitable.
What's up? What's behind this? Okay.
Meeting at 5:12? That's oddly specific.
Yeah, seriously, it's usually that. Like 5:30 or 5:00 or 5:45.
The CEO of Orochi was here. It makes no sense.
On Earth, that which counts.
It's probably a four-letter word. I should look around for some clues.
Wait, what if it's the,
The clock is stuck on 4:23.
Okay. Eden. What if it's Eden? E-D-E-N. No. Holy crap.
An emergency failsafe if Project Eclipse is released. If I can lower the shield, I can get out of this room.
But into what?
Once it is broken, the rush is upon you. You don't get to be the same person after they get in.
I'm getting out of here. I wonder if those consoles have anything to do with Project Eclipse.
Find a way out. Activate Project Escape. Eclipse, not Escape. You know what I mean. Leave me alone. What are we doing? What are we doing? What? Dang it. There we go. What? Come on. They're all at the same... It's all lit up except for that. Whatever.
So the Lord God banished him from the Garden of Eden to work the ground from which he had been taken. Genesis 3:23.
Doing in the middle there, Mr. Mouse. That's a fancy camera that looks like a gun. I got everything okay, right? I mean, I can't access this. There's another paper right there that told me what to do. What in the world? I can't move. Why can't I move?
What the hell is that thing?
You want me to open that, don't you? Yep. Of course you do.
That didn't work.
Of course.
There's gotta be a hint somewhere for the right setting on these dials.
Maybe Maybe it's 515, 512. Okay, 3 combo. Set 19. There's two numbers that I can do. 901 and 303. Okay, so 901. Let's try that one. There isn't. Okay, so let's try. No, come on. Don't do it. Would you stop doing that? There wasn't any zeros, so it was just...
Brilliance, yes. Let it connect.
Okay, can we not be in this room? Please? I don't know where we are.
Our family therapist's office. I can still smell the musty leather sofa in the corner. My parents took me here when I started having night terrors.
I understand some might consider my behavior obsessive. Yes.
Do I want to go out this door?
Can anyone tell me how to access the space between dreams?
What the heck? Access the space between dreams. Lucid dream?
Excellent try, Gloria. However, while the roads of Agartha do traverse the vastness of time and space, the corridors between dreams are a separate sort of passageway.
The doors of light.
And the two only intersect in very rare places.
Roads are said to be able to take one throughout space and time.
That's very cutting edge,
beamers?
Adam. And while the full answer to that is quite complex, that is still incorrect.
Wormholes and event horizon offer the possibility to go into impossible places. I get it. come out.
What a distinctive answer. That is an interesting theological paradox, but it is wrong.
God holds the keys to the doors of the entire universe. By his grace are we allowed to enter. How does one cross the space between dreams? This is the only right one?
Very good.
Dreaming
ones. Answer is the dreaming ones.
The dreaming ones were the one. The dreaming ones were, the dreaming ones are, and the dreaming ones shall be. Not in the spaces we know, but between. How does that make sense?
The dreaming ones were, the dreaming ones are, the dreaming ones shall be. Not in the spaces we know, but between. They walk serene and primal, undimensioned and to us unseen. They can teach us deep knowledge, secrets past the skin of eternity.
Well, this is
noticing when it's happening. Yesterday, I
interesting.
Saw a mote, illuminated, suspended in the air. Spent the remainder of the day in my office researching. I'm accused of isolating myself. I merely am who I am and have always been.
Wandering in time.
Isolated by knowledge. Imagine discovering a dictionary. I struggle with domesticity, but I had to make a choice.
Okay. That's gonna be it for this episode, guys. I know it's a short one, but yeah. Really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, hit that bell icon, comment down below, anything in general. And this is TT95 signing off. Bye, guys.